Here are the latest stories making headlines in the Filipino community.
The Philippines is ready and open to engage the United States, especially the business sector, to further strengthen trade and investments.
This is the Philippines' clear message during the country's economic briefing in Washington, D.C. Wednesday. Leading the economic team is Philippine Finance Secretary Benjamin Diokno, who says the Philippines welcomes foreign investments. With a high 7.6% GDP, a 4.8% unemployment rate, a strong and resilient manufacturing sector, and a strong fiscal performance.
Amid a challenging global environment, the Philippine economy has managed to weather the storms and stay the course towards sustainable economic growth.
The International Monetary Fund recently raised its growth forecast for the Philippine economy to 6% for 2023, which is faster than its 4.6% growth forecast for the whole of Asia and a 4.5% for Southeast Asia.
When Raptors shoot, she's screaming.
Over in the NBA, a 9-year-old Filipina stole the show during the Chicago Bulls-Toronto Raptors play-in game on Wednesday night. Deanne DeRozan, the daughter of Bulls small forward DeMar DeRozan and Filipina-American Kiara Morrison, went viral for her screams each time the Raptors were on the free throw line. The Bulls have dubbed DR as the MVP of the game, believing the Raptors' 18 missed free throws were caused by her 36 screams.
I haven't let it soak in yet. Everybody keeps saying, you know, but that's all right. I kept hearing something during the game, and it was one free throw somebody missed, and I looked back, and I was like, damn, that's my daughter screaming.
The Bulls were down by 19 points, but rallied to win a 109-105 victory. The Bulls will now visit the Miami Heat and Filipino-American head coach Eric Spoelstra on Friday for a chance to play in the playoffs. And finally, we head to San Francisco, where the Philippines' award-winning Ube Cream Liqueur had a soft launch in the U.S. at the Michelin Guide Abaca restaurant. The world's first Ube Cream Liqueur is crafted by Destilleria Baraco and made in the Philippines.
There's no actual liqueur, so we created that, you know, so that in every fiesta as well, you can have an Ube dessert, you can also have an Ube Cream Liqueur.
The drink is made from sugarcane vodka from Negus Province, coconut husk from Mindanao, and ube grown across the Philippine Islands.
It's sweet. It's only 70% alcohol.
Ube Cream Liqueur has won double gold in the cream liqueur category and the Product Innovation Award at the 2021 SIP Awards. It was also rated the world's best cream liqueur at the 2022 World Liqueur Awards. And those were the latest headlines from North America. You can catch our stories online at news.abs-cbn.com/TFCnews and on the ABS-CBN News YouTube channel. Back to you guys for the rundown.
An employee of the U.S. Air Force National Guard has been arrested over the online leak of highly classified U.S. documents. Washington did not provide further details about the suspect, except that he was arrested Thursday afternoon in Massachusetts.
The Justice Department arrested Jack Douglas Teixeira in connection with an investigation into alleged unauthorized removal, retention, and transmission of classified national defense information. He will have an initial appearance at the U.S. District Court for the District of Massachusetts. We will share more information at the appropriate time.
The leak of Intel documents is seen as one of the worst security breaches in the U.S. since the 2013 WikiLeaks scandal. The documents, labeled secret and top secret, first appeared on social media sites in March. They contain details of military capabilities of some of America's rivals and even allies.
As for U.S. President Joe Biden, he says he's not overly concerned about the leak of highly classified U.S. documents. This, despite mounting concerns from the international community, with Britain saying there was a serious level of inaccuracy in that information.
There is a full-blown investigation going on, as you know, with the intelligence community and the Justice Department, and they're getting close. I don't have an answer.
I'm not concerned
about the late years. I'm concerned that it happened. But there's nothing contemporaneous that I'm aware of that is of great consequence.
China calls for restraint on the Korean Peninsula. This after North Korea launched a new type ballistic missile Thursday. The Chinese Foreign Ministry asserts the rising tensions in the region are linked to America's large-scale military exercises in the region. Back in March, South Korea and the U.S. held an 11-day joint military drills. China hopes the parties involved will stay calm as it urges the U.S. to de-escalate the tension.
Taiwan holds civil defense drills in its central Taichung city days after China concluded war games around the island. The pre-planned annual series of drills were modified to include elements of warfare amid the conflict in Ukraine and a heightened sense of threat from China. And meanwhile, visiting U.S. Senator John Hoeven expressed his concern over China's aggressive action in a meeting with Taiwan President Tsai Ing-wen. He said Washington will continue to provide arms to the self-ruled Democratic Island. Filipino troops are trained on the use of an anti-tank missile system that has helped Ukraine fight off Russian invaders. The training is part of the Philippines' largest joint military drills with the U.S. Joyce Valancho reports.
Last year, the United States sent modern weapons to help Ukraine fend off Russian invaders and reclaim occupied territories. It includes Javelin anti-tank missiles that have been proven effective in taking out Russia's armored vehicles and tanks. After seeing what it can do, Philippine Army Commanding General Romeo Browner said the government expressed interest in procuring this weapon system. On Thursday, Filipino and American troops conducted live fire exercises, showing the results of their training under the Salakmip 2023 exercises held last month. These drills were carried out days after the formal opening of the Balikatan exercises, which is a different training platform.
We know for a fact that the Philippine Army has to develop its capabilities to make sure that we will be able to use the modern weapons that are now available. We are seeing in the Ukraine and Russia conflict the use of these modern weapons. And so we want to also bring that capability to the Philippine Army in order for us to be able to bolster our defensive posture and be able to defend our territory.
Browner adds the anti-tank weapon could also be used in counterinsurgency efforts and other possible security threats.
All the scenarios that we are doing here in the exercise are not specifically targeting any adversary. So we're not saying it's against any country or any specific group of our adversaries, but we want to prepare for all kinds of threats that could come to our country, whether it be man-made or natural.
We are standing here next to each other as military leaders, and our political leadership stood shoulder to shoulder just a couple of days ago in Washington, D.C. And so I think that what this represents is an extension of that, is an operationalization of the commitment to one another and for a safe, a stable, a free, and open Indo-Pacific that everyone, you know, gets to benefit from.
The first phase of the Salakmip exercises occurred days before China conducted live fire drills near Taiwan. Browner, however, stressed that the recent games had nothing to do with the rising tensions in the West Philippine Sea.
The Salakmip exercises that we're doing are all in line with the order of our president for us to defend our territory and not give an inch of our territory. So all of this are geared towards that, towards achieving his order.
Joyce Balancho, ABS-CBN News, Nueva Ecija.